Neuroscience 2018, researchers presented new breakthroughs in the understanding of the aging brain that could have enormous impacts on the way we prevent, detect, and treat Alzheimer's and vascular dementia, a form of dementia caused by reduced blood flow to the brain, often through repeated minor strokes. At the University of Singapore, researchers studied sphingosine 1-phosphate, a molecule that reduces inflammation in brain cells. They found that lower levels of S1P had a direct correlation to increased risk of vascular dementia.
We looked at how S1P compares to between Alzheimer's disease patients and normal patients, and we saw no differences. But when we stratified that and looked specifically at vascular dementia patients, then there was a significant reduction. The result is that we think that we can use this to diagnose people with vascular dementia based on a blood test, and possibly even to predict how severe their disease might be. We're still looking into that now.
The ability to diagnose vascular dementia through a blood test would be a significant advancement. Using S1P to mitigate vascular dementia before symptoms even develop would be another.
From my perspective, I think what's more exciting is the fact that since we see that it modulates inflammation, we might actually be able to develop drugs that can target the system and reduce the overall level of inflammation in dementia patients and then slow down the disease progression.
Decreased function of the lymphatic system is another strong indicator of neurodegeneration. According to a study from the University of Virginia, researchers found that mice without functional lymph drainage vessels performed worse on learning and memory tests and displayed increased buildup of amyloid plaques in brain cells.
What we really know is that if these vessels are dysfunctional, this is not good for brain function, for instance, for hippocampal function. That's one of the brain regions that is involved, for instance, in learning and memory.
Researchers have found that restoring lymphatic vessels improves behavioral and cognitive function.
What we also know is that if you have an old mouse where these vessels are dysfunctional, if you improve the drainage by these vessels, you're also impacting all of this function of these brain regions, and also this behavioral dysfunction that you see with aging is also kind of improved.
The cardiovascular system plays a similarly large role in brain health. At McGill University, researchers have been studying the relationship between blood vessel inflammation and dementia. In doing so, they have discovered a non-pharmacological treatment for vascular dementia, exercise.
So in vascular dementia and even in Alzheimer's, actually, there's evidence that there's a lot of inflammation around blood vessels. So that actually kind of impairs their communication within the rest of the brain.
Researchers found that regular cardiovascular exercise worked to lower white matter inflammation, slowing and even preventing the effects of vascular dementia.
From our study, we're confident in saying that exercise is able to improve blood flow in the brain. So our findings are really encouraging because we're showing evidence that there's kind of these early signs that might be worth targeting. So if there are drug companies that can now kind of target therapies towards white matter inflammation, and even working with people that are looking at multiple sclerosis, because they're really trying to work at kind of fixing the problems we see in white matter.